in life that you do, it is a package deal. So in my life, let me tell you, first of all, I was a very, very naughty kid who loved playing sport, and cricket was the ultimate thing for me. And when India won the World Cup in 1983, I wanted to lift that trophy one day. I was watching that live, and I didn't understand the significance of having won the World Cup, you know, because everyone was dancing and celebrating, jumping around me. I also joined that gang and started celebrating, not knowing how big, you know, the achievement was. And one thing which stayed with me was that beautiful trophy, you know, in Kapil Dev's hands, though, that beautiful trophy looked fabulous. And that sight of Indian cricket team celebrating in the balcony of Lords stayed with me. And I wanted to do the same thing. And that's how my journey started. Then I went to Shivaji Park. My brother Ajit took me to Achrekar Sir. And various things happened. First, of course, when I went there, I was so tense and nervous. I was not able to connect the ball at all. And my coach quietly told my brother, you know, aur 6-8 mahina jaane do, baad mein we will see. There is still some time to go. And he requested my coach, you know, just usko 10 minute dena, aur aap please net ke piche mat khade rahiyega. He is tense right now, but I know for sure that he can bat a bit. And my brother, having played cricket, he understood, you know, he had spotted that spark in me. So luckily, Achrekar sir went aside and I was able to enjoy cricket without being tense. And I struck few good shots. After that, started my school tournament. And Harry Shiel and Gail Shiel, I started scoring runs. No access to all these fancy gadgets now. Today we have all these smartphones all the time around us. They've become our, you know, constant companion now. But those days, we didn't have access to all those things. So today, if somebody has to find out, okay, what are the tournaments coming up in the next 3 months or 4 months? Literally within a couple of minutes, you'll be able to find out everything on your phone. I had no idea about that. I went out to play and enjoy cricket, and I wanted to live in that moment. It rather, I would say, it allowed me to live in that moment. And for anything in life, you got to plan, you got to prepare yourself, but eventually when you go out to perform and it's time to deliver, you got to live in that moment. Somewhere it happened to me, I stayed in that moment. Every time I would ask my brother, ki aata kai next? So he would say, okay, next match you have to go out and score runs, then maybe they might consider you for under 15 Mumbai. If you get runs there, you might go to under 17, under 19, so on and so forth. But I had no clue about the tournaments played around. I just kept going match by match, and I wanted to better my performance match by match. Everything happened rather quickly in my life. When I was in 9th standard, I was part of the Mumbai Ranji Trophy team, where Dilip Vinsarkar was the captain, and at that time he was the captain of Indian team also. And the first season, I got to play with all these stalwarts, and I was the highest run getter for Mumbai team that season. So that gave me a lot of confidence. I felt that yes, I belong here, and I've rightfully earned my spot there in the team. It is always a special feeling when you've got these stalwarts around you and you end up performing better than the most of your colleagues, and they encourage you, they appreciate your performance. I thought that was the best tonic for me to go out and work harder. I continued doing that, and then suddenly there were talks about, oh, would Sachin be picked to play for India? And that time Mr. Raj Singh Dungarpur, who was the chairman of the selection committee that time, he came and he told me that you will not be going to West Indies. you focus on your SSC exams, and then you focus on the next season, and we'll see. That day is not too far off. If you continue to play the way you have played last season, that day is not far off. And then I scored another 100 on my Irani Trophy debut. I got selected for India. I went to Pakistan. Pakistan was indeed a big, big tour for me. For anyone, but sometimes it helps to be 16. You know, I had no clue what I was getting into. I did not have any idea the kind of bowling attack I was going to face. You know, I was just treating that like another Ranji Trophy match. But the moment I went there, I realized, I played few overs there, and I realized, oh, this is rather difficult. And I got back to the dressing room. I'd only scored 15 runs. I got back to the dressing room, and I started actually questioning my ability. I started questioning my career. And I thought I was at the wrong place at the wrong time. I said, this is not made for me. Test cricket is too difficult. It's too tough to handle. And I almost went to the bathroom and I cried, literally. But then there were players around me who inspired me, who helped me, encouraged me, and told me exactly what needs to be done. And I was receptive to that. And all I was praying for was another opportunity. So when I got another chance in the next test match, the plan was to go out and not look at the scoreboard. I was only looking at the clock. I had decided that first half an hour, I'm just going to try and be there. Even if it is a rough period for me, I'm going to ride through that and try and take as much time to settle, calm down. And exactly that is what happened. Whatever the players had told me, that is what happened. I spent time, and then I suddenly started believing, oh, I can handle this. I can manage this. And I scored 59 runs in the second test match, the second innings of my life, the first innings in the first test. And I didn't get to bat in the second innings. But this was the second time I went out to bat. And I actually believed that, oh, I belong here. And that day was the turning point of my life. As far as I'm concerned, in my head, I started believing that I can handle this. And I was possibly playing the best bowling attack in the world at that time. It was Imran, Wasim, Waqar, Aqib Javed, Abdul Qadir. So all these, you know, top class bowlers who were constantly having a go at me and challenging me. After that tour, things became different. I played various roles in life, from a junior most player to I was nominated the vice captain of the team, and then soon became a captain, and then the senior most player in the team. But at all times, you know, preparation was critical for me. People sometimes tend to think that initially it will be difficult, but later on it will get easier. In fact, later on it might get tougher and tougher, because along with your performances, people start expecting more and more from you. And being at the top doesn't happen on its own. It requires commitment, it requires discipline, dedication, willingness to work harder than the rest of the guys around you. When all these things get together, that is when there is one seat at the top, which everyone is fighting for. And you get there, but it's not a permanent spot. If you need to stay there, you need to prepare yourself to work harder than the rest. And I enjoyed. I never looked at it, I never looked at the clock. When we were playing, when we were practicing, it was all about what my heart said and not what my brain said. It was not about impressing someone. It was more about satisfying my hunger, because I was hungry. I wanted to be on the ground. However many hours I spent there, they were not enough for me. There were occasions where my coach literally had to drag me out of the net and say, now we can barely see each other. Forget about seeing the ball, but we can barely see each other. You got to go home. But I enjoyed doing that. You know, nobody forced me. And that is what I would tell all of you, that anything that you want to be in life, you need not be just cricketer. You know, I'm a cricketer, but I'm a sportsman. You play any sport, you got to remember that there are no shortcuts. And please don't take shortcuts. If anyone encourages you, please don't take shortcuts. Because in sports, what happens? You are out in front of the whole world. You're out in the middle. You know, 30, 40,000 people watching you all the time, and everything is covered live. You're going to get exposed there. There is no place to hide there. So rather embrace all those challenges and prepare yourself for that. And the satisfaction of having performed in front of them and having done something for a country, it is just incomparable. So my message to you is chase your dreams. That is what I did. I dreamt when I was 10-year-old. I dreamt of playing cricket for India. And it happened. Slowly it happened. Nothing happens overnight. You got to be persistent and you got to be patient. And you have to plan and then you have to execute those plans. And as long as you're prepared to take those challenges along the way, because if you feel that if you practice hard and everything's going to get easy, no, it's not. There are going to be challenges, and it happened to me till the last day of my career. There were challenges, but that is why we practice. We practice so that we could face all those challenges. And I'm so sure that you guys are going to go out, practice, and give your best at all times. There is no greater honor than representing the nation. When I got my India cap, that was the greatest feeling of my life. The only thing that topped that feeling was lifting the World Cup for India. I'm sure you guys are going to try your best and push hard, because you need to aspire to be something special in life. That is really, really important. Set tough targets for yourself. Don't settle for something which is achievable easily. You know, you need to really work hard for it to be able to achieve certain things in life. And when you are able to get there, the whole country is proud of you. And I'm sure you'll do that. I don't want to keep giving you lecture, but this was my message to you. All the very best.